Like maybe 12 o'clock, wasn't it? And when we got out of church, them young folks sprung up another service. They're gonna go ahead and have another preaching. They started at it around about 12 o'clock, something like that. Almost 12 o'clock. They were gonna go and do a second round. We couldn't hang one for that. We had to leave. Y'all go ahead and have it. It's past my bedtime. I'm about to go home. We was driving away. They were just singing their heart out. My Lord, beautiful time. Had a beautiful time, amen. We give God the praise today. We give God the glory. Thank God for everyone that came today to the service of God, amen. Amen. We're dealing today with nothing but the blood. Dealing with the blood of Christ. The importance of having the blood of Jesus. The importance of walking in the blood and in the spirit. The importance of being baptized in the blood of Jesus. Amen. A lot of times people say the blood, they talk about the blood, and they say, I'm covered by the blood. Do you really understand what that means? It ain't just being church yet. There's some power in the blood. Amen. There's some healing in the blood. Hallelujah. There's some deliverance in the blood. Amen. The importance of being wrapped up, tied up, tangled up in the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's go to the word of God today. Before we go to the word of God, I got a couple of definitions of the blood. Amen. 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 The basic definition of the blood. If the basic definition of the blood is the blood contains is the red fluid that circulates in the artery and veins of human beings and other vertebrates. Amen. Amen. And what it does, it takes oxygen. Praise the Lord, to the body, amen? It transport oxygen, amen? That's the basic definition of blood. Amen, the basic definition of blood. And you know, blood contains several components, amen? Contains about approximately 4 components. You got white blood cell, you got red blood cell, amen, amen? You got plasma, amen? And you have platelets, that's a part of the blood. And blood, the basic definition of blood, you got 4 blood types. Actually, you got A blood type, B blood type, actually it's A blood type, it's A blood type, it's B blood type, it's AB blood type, and it's O blood type. But along with the blood types that you have positive, you got A positive, you got A negative, you got B positive, you got B negative, you got AB positive, you got AB negative, you got O positive, and you got O negative. Praise the Lord. So blood is very important to have in your body. How many of y'all know you cannot live without blood? You cannot function without blood. A person that has a bleeding disorder is considered to be what? A hemophiliac, right? Hemophilia. It's when you're bleeding, praise the Lord, you get scratched and you don't stop bleeding. And you will die if somebody don't give you some blood. If you ever get in a car wreck, praise the Lord, you start bleeding. If anybody ever shoots you, praise the Lord, you start bleeding. You're going to die if you start bleeding out without blood. You got to have blood. And that's just the carnal side of blood. That's just the natural side of blood. Today we're dealing with blood. Nothing but the blood. The importance of the blood of God. Somebody said, nothing but the blood, so help me God. A lot of times they'll tell you to have you swear in, have you swear in the court, they say, tell the truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. But I'm here to say, the daddy said, nothing but the blood, so help me God. Don't depend on your own righteousness. Don't depend on your own holiness. You got to get wrapped up, tied up, covered by the blood. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter number 4. Verse number 8 through 10. Elect Lady John, please read. Dealing with the blood. Somebody said the blood.
Blood.
Somebody said the blood.
Blood.
Go ahead and read it, Elect Lady John. Genesis chapter 4, verse number 8 through 10.
And Cain talked with Abel, his brother. And it came to pass, when they were in the field, that Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and slew him. And the Lord said unto Cain, where is Abel, thy brother? And he said, I know not. Am I my brother's keeper? And he said, what hast thou done? The voice of thy brother's blood cried unto me from the ground.
The voice of your brother's blood is crying unto you from the grave. Therefore, as preachers of the gospel, as ministers of the word of God, it's more than just having a profession. It's more than being the shot caller in the house of God. You're going to be held accountable for the blood that's of mankind. That's what's important, to stay in the truth. If I don't have time to vacillate over here, I don't have time to vacillate over here. I got to stay true to the blood. Amen? In today's society, you go out there and commit a crime. Forensic science will tell you. How they track people down sometimes is because they misuse the blood. They spill the blood. Oh, you got a little blood on the carpet and you couldn't get it up. They got ways of going and check that car. Look like you got it all cleaned up, praise the Lord. Look like ain't no spots there. They go in with their little instrument and their little tool kit and they go down deep and they pick it up and they pick it out and they say, oh, that's some blood. She was on tight, on negative, praise the Lord. And the blood that we found in your apartment was on negative. The blood that we saw in your truck was on negative. The blood that was on your leg in your kitchen was on negative. That you discovered by the blood. The blood has the ability to cry out. And your blood, if it ain't saved, is crying out. It's crying out for Jesus this morning. No matter how old you think you are, you may say, I'm the captain of my own ship. I'm the Lord of my own ship. That's just a lie. Your blood is crying out for Jesus.
And he said, what hast thou done? The voice of thy brother's blood crieth unto me from the ground. And now art thou cursed from the earth, which hath opened her mouth to receive thy brother's blood from thy hand.
You're cursed because you misused the blood. You're cursed because you misused the blood. So whenever you sin, you're misusing the blood that God gave you, and you're misusing the blood and the grace of God that he shed on Calvary's cross. Let's go to Genesis chapter number. Now, I'm just scratching the tip of the iceberg today. We ain't got time to talk about everything about the blood, but we're going to hear some points about the blood today. Genesis chapter number 9 and verse number 4 through 6. Amen?
But the flesh with the life thereof, which is the blood thereof, shall ye not eat. And surely your blood of your lives will I require. At the hand of every beast will I require it. And at the hand of man, at the hand of every man's brother, will I require the life of man.
God did not take that blood lightly. See, when we take it lightly, It's just the red stuff that flows through my veins. Praise God. No, God considered that blood very important. He even had a dietary requirement. How many of y'all love steak? Baby, you gotta let that steak get well done. Get all that blood cooked out of it. And somebody say, it ain't just right. And some people put that steak on their plate and still bleed. That's right. Baby, y'all want that. I ain't trying to tell you what to do. If that's you, that's when you and God. But the Bible said, don't eat up the blood. I like mine rare. Baby, you got blood coming out of you. I wouldn't do it. And even though we ain't a part of the old covenant nowadays, it can make you sick. You need that blood, it can make you sick. Let that thing sit on the grill and get that blood cooked out of it. Amen. Oh my goodness, keep reading. Let's go to Genesis chapter number 37. Dealing with the blood today, amen. So he told him you can't eat everything with blood off it. Yeah! Getting sick because of the blood. Food ain't half cooked because the blood's still in it. Have anybody been cooking some chicken and then you put that fork in that chicken and blood came out? It's got to stay in the grease a little longer. It ain't time to come off the grill yet. Put that one back on the grill for a little bit longer. Let it just sit there and cook a little bit until the blood stops coming out of it. Amen! Genesis chapter number 37, verse number 22 through 26. And like I said, I don't have time today to cover everything. We're just gonna skim the tip of the iceberg today. But I'm here to tell you the importance of having the blood of God covering you. Please read Genesis
And Reuben said unto them, shed no blood, but cast him into his into this pit that is in the wilderness, and lay no hands upon him, that he might rid him of their hands to deliver him to his father again. And it came to pass when Joseph was come unto his brethren.
That's good right there. Reuben had some problems. What did Reuben that he said, unstable as water in Genesis chapter number 39, thou shalt not prosper because you went upon my bed and you done something you had no business doing. It may have been Reuben, but Reuben had an epiphany. Reuben had an understanding that he didn't want to mess up the blood of his brother. Reuben had an understanding. Don't mess with his blood. Don't shed his blood. That my backside is so bad because we're shedding the blood of Jesus again. Our brother Lord is a more bad. Just go out there and get your groove on. You're spilling the blood of Jesus. You're wasting the blood of Jesus. You're playing with the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Please read.
And it came to pass.
Let's stop. Let's drop down to Genesis chapter 42, verse 15 to 22. See, Reuben understood that don't mess with his blood. Reuben was trying to deliver his brother from them, but they took his brother anyway and sold him away. But they did take heed to what Reuben, their older brother, told him. Don't mess with it. Don't kill him. They said, why should we kill him when we can make some money out of him? Why should we kill him, praise the Lord, when we can sell him away and get some change in our pocket? So they didn't slay him. They didn't destroy the blood. Genesis chapter 42, verse 15.
Hereby ye shall be proved by the life of Pharaoh. Ye shall not go forth hence, except your youngest brother come hither.
Stop right there. The unshakable, the unbreakable law of the harvest is that you're going to reap what you sow. Somebody say the unbreakable, the unshakable, the unchangeable law of the heart. It may look like you're getting away with it right now, but the unbreakable, the unshakable law of the heart is going to demand something from you. They sold him into captivity, and now it's his turn to play with them. After all the low down and dirty stuff that his brothers had done, sold him away to the Israelites. I think it was his. They sold him away. He sold him away. And then they sold him away. And now he's in Egypt, fulfilling what God has ordained for him. Yes. His purpose in Egypt, probably grown a beard, got it all his hair cut off, and looking like an Egyptian, praise the Lord. And got an interpreter talking to him, acting like he don't even know what they're talking about. Okay, but let me let you know something. After all these years, Reuben's still going to remember, I told you.
Send one of you and let him fetch your brother, and ye shall be kept in prison, that your words may be proved, whether there be any truth in you, or else by the life of Pharaoh, surely ye are spies.
And, let's go ahead and read.
And he put them all together into a ward 3 days. And Joseph said unto them the third day, this do and live, for I fear God. If ye be true men, let one of your brethren be bound in the house of your prison. Go ye, carry corn for the famine of your houses. But bring your youngest brother unto me. So shall your words be verified, and ye shall not die. And they did so. And they said one to another, we are verily guilty concerning our brother, in that we saw the anguish of his soul when he besought us, and we would not hear, therefore is this distress come upon us.
Wow. Can you read, please?
And Reuben answered them, saying, spake I not unto you, saying, do not sin against the child? And ye would not hear, therefore, behold, also his blood is required.
Since you did not use wisdom, you did not let it go, his blood. See, they thought he was dead. Reuben probably thought he was dead. But guess what? His blood was, he was still, in other words, he said, I told y'all, don't mess with the blood. Somebody playing with the blood. See, they got this thing. We fall down And we get up. Don't that sound beautiful? We fall down and get up. Y'all remember that song? We fall down and get up. For a saint is just a sinner who fell down and got back up. And let me let y'all know something. The Bible says all have sinned.
That's right.
Have come short of the glory of God. Amen. You may have never fallen, but you still was a sinner.
Yes, Lord.
And you still came short of the glory and the grace of God. Amen. But once you get delivered,
amen,
once you get set free, if I were you and you was me, I would run on to see what the end gonna be. Because you never know where death lies. You never know when the Lord will say, I'm tired of your mess. I'm tired of your foolishness. I'm tired. And how about this? God don't say none of that. Your time just run out. I gave you 27 years on this earth to get my job done. And if you ain't done it 27 years, you out of here. I gave you 20 years to do what I'm calling you to do. And mama didn't know it. Daddy didn't know it. When you broke the matrix and came here to this earth realm, you assumed that you was going to be here 27 years. I mean, 70 years plus. God said, I only gave you 40 years. Only gave you 15 years to get it right. Only gave you 50, 60 years to get it right. And there's somebody out there just running from God. I'm running, Pastor. I will get saved, but I'm running, Lord. Lord, when I get old and I can't, and I gotta come to the house of God with a crutch or with a cane or a wheelchair, then I'm gonna give my life to Jesus. Let me let you know something. Your life ain't never your life. It was given you from God, and at any time God wanna take it from you, He can take it from you right now. You don't own your life. You don't own the breath that is in your mouth. It is given to you and given to me from God. How many people have gotten out of their car, woken up that morning, kissed the wife, and praise the Lord, kissed the children goodbye, kissed the husband goodbye, and never made it home? Me and my wife got this thing. We never wake up mad at each other. I don't even want to go to work without having any issue that may happen. We don't even believe in going down and going to bed with letting the sun set with anger and all this kind of stuff. And people have problems in their marriage. They go on weeks, go on years, go on months, and they don't solve that problem. You don't never know when I'm going to leave and never come back from work. Some people was going to work and never made it. Had they planned all mapped out for the week. They going over here. They going over there. They got the planner down pat. They got everything mapped out, and it never come to pass. Don't play with God. And don't play with His blood. But remember, we'll see, God is going to have mercy, and He's going to eventually reveal Himself to His brothers. I know y'all was low down and dirty and all that kind of stuff, treated me like trash and sold me away and all that kind of stuff. But in Genesis chapter number 50 and verse 20, he said, you meant it for evil, but God meant it unto good to bring the past as it is this day to save much people alive. You were trying to be low down and dirty, but God had a plan. You were trying to hold me back, but God had a plan. Hallelujah. Somebody said nothing but the blood. Need that blood to watch us today. Exodus chapter number 12. Amen. We ain't going to read all of it. I want to read all of it, but some, the time will not permit us to read all of it. Dealing with the Passover. Pharaoh had done so much low down and dirty stuff to Egypt, to Moses and the children of Egypt. They were supposed to make bricks without hay, without straw. He said, y'all gonna find a way to get it, but you still gotta do it. He was being low down and dirty too. Being cruel and mean and brutish. But we ain't started, when Moses, God started using Moses and Aaron to drop them plagues on Egypt. That old flesh of Pharaoh, that old will of Pharaoh, that old heart and heart of Pharaoh would not allow Pharaoh to give up. God said, I got one more plague. And when I'm done with them, they ain't gonna only let you go, they're gonna kick you out. He said, they ain't gonna only let you go. They're gonna kick you out. And when you come out, they're gonna spoil. Please leave. Take this jewelry, take these rings, and take this gold, and take this silk. I don't need. Take it and go. Hallelujah. Yeah, Exodus chapter number 12. Dealing with the Passover. 7.
And they shall take the blood and strike it on the two side posts and on the upper door posts of the houses wherein they shall eat it.
They were supposed to get a lamb and slay the lamb and get the blood. Somebody say, get the blood.
Get the blood.
Get the blood from the lamb. And what they're going to do, they're going to put it upon the door posts of their houses. This is the Passover they're talking about, y'all. Which was symbolic of the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus. He represents the lamb without spot, wrinkle, or blemish. Amen?
Yeah.
Keep reading, please.
And they shall eat the flesh in that night, roast with fire, and unleavened bread, and with bitter herbs they shall eat it.
Skip down to verse 13 for the sake of time.
And the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where ye are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you.
And when I see what?
The blood.
And when I see the blood. See, deliverance is coming by the blood of Jesus. Healing is coming by the blood of Jesus. So that was important to be covered by the blood. Not be covered by your own holiness. And not be covered by your own right. But you got to be covered by the blood of Jesus. He said, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I'm going to pass over. He said, when I see the blood. Hallelujah. Drop down to verse 22.
And ye shall take a bunch of hyssop and dip it in the blood that it is in the basin and strike the lintel and the two side posts with the blood that is in the basin. And none of you shall go out at the door of his house until the morning. For the Lord would pass through to smite the Egyptians. And when he seeth the blood upon the lintel and on the two side posts, the Lord would pass over the door and would not suffer the destroyer to come in unto your houses to smite you.
But they had to obey. See, a lot of times we come to church and we don't obey. The word of God coming, we hear it, and it's just Pastor Jones up there. That's just Mama J up there. That's just Minister Glover up there. Praise the Lord. Minister Breeze up there. Minister Taj Craig Glover up there. Minister Bass up there. Minister Claw, Minister Miles. Praise the Lord. Minister Miles is preaching the word, but I ain't got to listen to it. Oh, praise the Lord. I ain't got to obey what the word of God has said. The devil is a lie. That's the word that's coming from God, and he's calling for you to change. This prophet is caught up there preaching to us. We ain't got to change. You keep right on. Keep right on. Keep right on playing. Prophet is kind of up there. There she go. There she go. She telling me you did. I need to hear you. Keep on playing. Keep right on playing. Keep right on playing with that blood. Let's go to Exodus. Let's go to Hebrews chapter number 9. And I got to read as much of this as I can, y'all. Because this is some teaching today. Let you know about the importance of the blood covering. Yeah. Somebody said, nothing but the blood.
Nothing but the blood.
Nothing but the blood, so help me God. Nothing but the blood. I need it, Lord. Gotta have it. Amen. Can't live without it. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God in Hebrews chapter number 9. Amen. Whenever you get that, please say amen.
Amen.
And verse number, let's start with verse number 1. Go ahead. Read. Start reading a little like John.
Then verily the first covenant had also ordinances of divine service.
Yes.
And a worldly sanctuary.
Yes.
For there was a tabernacle made. The first wherein was the candlestick and the table and the showbread, which is called the sanctuary.
Yes.
And after the second veil, the tabernacle, which is called the holiest of all, which had the golden censer and the ark of the covenant overlaid round about with gold.
Yes.
Wherein was the golden pot that had manna and Aaron's rod that budded and the tables of the covenant.
Yes.
And over it, the cherubims of glory shadowing the mercy seat, of which we cannot now speak particularly.
Keep reading, please.
Now, when these things were thus ordained, the priests went always into the first tabernacle, accomplishing the services of God.
So, in other words, the priest could only take you so far. No matter how good your bishop is, no matter how good your high anointed, you said your apostle is, how anointed your prophet, a prophetess, or evangelist, a pastor, teach, they can only take you so far.
That's right.
Please read.
But in the second, when the high priest alone, once every year, not without blood, which is offered for himself and for the errors of the people.
In other words, God said, don't come up into the Holy of Holies without the blood. Okay, we can play church outside of the sanctuary, outside of the first level of it. In church, outside of the first level, we jump and shout. In church, we sing praises and all that kind of stuff. In church, we raise our hands and they living us. We come to the house of God. That's the first level of it. We're doing service without the blood. But if you want to get closer and if you want to go deeper, you got to come through the blood. You got to dip up in the blood. You got to praise up in the blood. Don't come up into the holies of holies without the blood. That's why we're at today's church. We don't know how to level. We're just in the first part of the sanctuary. We're in the first part of the tabernacle. But if you want to get closer to God, you better bathe off in that blood. And you better act like you got the blood on you. You better come up in there with the blood all over you. Come, wash me from the, dip me in the blood from the crown of my head, Lord, to the sole of my feet, Lord. Wash me, cleanse me. Cover me by the blood, Lord Jesus.
The Holy Ghost, this signifying that the way into the holiest of all was not yet made manifest, while as the first tabernacle was yet standing,
keep reading, please.
Which was a figure for the time then present, in which were offered both gifts and sacrifices that could not make him that did the service perfect as pertaining to the conscience.
Keep reading, please.
Which stood only in meats and drinks and divers washings and carnal ordinances imposed on them until the time of Reformation.
Yes, please keep reading.
But Christ being come and high priest of good things to come by a greater and more perfect tabernacle.
Yes.
Not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building.
Yes.
Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood, he entered into once into the holy place, having obtained
his own blood. His own blood. See, that's why that blood is precious. It's the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Well, I can do what I want to do in my own life. When I get good and ready, I'm just saying, you keep on believing that, John. You keep on believing that you're going to lift your eyes up in haste. When God is calling you, you need to